Sydney's escalating gang wars have claimed another victim, the 23-year-old nephew of slain crime boss Mahmoud Brownie Ahmad. The young father was shot dead by gunmen waiting at his Belmore home, his heavily pregnant wife beside him as he died.
Anger and anguish. The devastated family of the latest victim in a deadly gangland war.
No one deserves this. This is atrocious.
4 a.m. in a sleeping suburban street in Belmore when silence was snapped by this. Gunman opening fire, fleeing the scene, leaving his pregnant wife to make the horrific discovery. Help arrived, but Rami Iskander could not be saved. A 23-year-old carpenter, a young father of two, and the nephew of a slain gangster.
He's Brownie Ahmed's nephew and part of that cabal.
Today's shooting is the 13th gangland execution in just 18 months, starting with the ambush of Comanchero bikey Ferez Abunaida in August 2020. A string of tit-for-tat shootings followed across Sydney's southwest. Then in June last year, Bilal Hamzi, cousin of Brothers for Life founder Bassam Hamzi, was gunned down in the CBD. More deadly attacks followed before Bassam Hamzi's brother, Ghassan Amun, was shot dead in January. Then Mahmoud Brownie Ahmad executed in Greenacre last month with a $1 million bounty on his head. And Omar's ahead this week in Auburn. 4 days later, this.
We've clearly got a war of sorts in southwestern Sydney around drug supply and organised crime. That crosses over with interfamily relationships.
Detectives will be following up all lines of inquiry, including whether the 23-year-old was involved in the planning of a revenge attack for his slain uncle and became a victim himself.
The hunt is tonight on for the gunmen. They fled Belmore in a black Audi, abandoning it in Croydon Park, picking up a Toyota SUV which had been parked there for days.
That car's been there for 2 days or more. So obviously that was their plan.
Well, they were parked up the road watching it burn, making sure that it was on fire.
They then torched that second getaway car in Bexley North.
Just another day in the hood.
There is no reason to all these bad behaviours to happen here.
But it continues to happen. The opposition calling for more to be done.
We need to make sure that the police have the resources to take on these organised violent thugs in an organised way.
Let's go to Bill Hogan, who's at police headquarters tonight. Bill, good evening. Two deadly attacks in days. The pressure is really on investigators.
Yeah, Michael, 7 News understands that the Premier is considering taking control of this gang war response himself. It's understood that he is looking at calling upon the previous police commissioner, Mick Fuller, as well as the former police minister, David Elliott, to help out. It's an extraordinary step that risks undermining the current police commissioner, Karen Webb, and the current operation in place. But I'm told that senior police are furious by remarks made last week that they are going to start kicking down doors, saying they've been doing that for the last year. Now, things are certainly escalating, Michael. It is a fire that needs to be put out fast.
Bill Hogan, thank you for that.